just gotta wait till we get down here.
Well, we got it.
How are you
doing? Made
it. All right. Wow.
Thanks,
buddy.
Yeah,
nice. All right, thanks. Great. How do you know if you're
going to be too late
or did you go home?
How much?
I think it's been a little bit too much rain. I don't know. I was just going to be up to be up here.
Next year. A lot of people up here this morning.
There used to be, there would be a whole bunch more.
Yeah, that's right.
He's a local fella that wanted to say a few words to you this morning.
I'd like to say first off, my name is Reverend James Johnson. I'm the pastor of Old Occupy One Baptist Church. I would like to tell you a couple of incidents, one very sweet and one very sincere. There was a man named Paul once upon a time that was on trial for his life for preaching the Word of God. There was a governor that heard these words, and he said, Paul, he said, you have done went crazy. You studied the Bible so much till it drove you crazy. But Paul said, no, King Agrippa, I wish that you would hear me and believe me. And Agrippa said, almost thou persuadest me to be a Christian. Paul said, I would to God that not only I could persuade you, but all that hear me, and this is my plea to you this morning, I would that not only I could persuade you, but all that hear me this morning, foolish and die before your time. I would that we would reverence God now in prayer, then I'll dismiss myself. Heavenly Fathers, we bow before you this morning. It's a privilege, dear God, to call upon your name. Yet, Father, knowing that one day, dear Lord God, that we're going to meet you face to face. Father, you said that we was going to have to give an account for this day and every other day, dear God. Father, I come to you this day on behalf of the men and women, young or old, that may be here this day. I come on behalf of them, Father, asking you for a joyful day for them, dear God. But, Father, I ask you some way, somehow or other, to let these few words sink deep.
Because all of you, need to be riders out there? No? One? We're going to cut the B-Riders off at the second gas. It rained a little bit last night. It might be a little bit boggy in the last loop.
That means B-Riders don't get to ride at all?
No, not quite. Where's Travis Johnson?
I seen him going down the highway.
Left! On the second loop, 53.0, you go straight. Where's Kevin Hutchins?
Right here.
You got that?
I got it.
You got that.
Is any different designation in error?
Huh?
As far as the errors this morning, there's going to be two sets
up. Oh, yeah. The errors will be up. I just know that, like Kevin Hutchinson, people will go where the errors ain't sometimes. Now, at the beginning of the, it might be a little confusing. It's not supposed to be. Get your second gas and head east for the third loop, if you so desire. We're going to meet a 35-mile-an-hour speed limit on Tank Trail. There are MPs out there. They got M16s. It's a different type of test section. If you get stopped by an MP, whatever you got to do. Has everybody seen a tank? If you haven't seen a tank, you're getting ready to, because they're going to be running this tank trail. That's why they call it the tank trail. They're big. There will be a limited amount of two-way traffic on the tank trail, on the motorcycles. We're going to have early rows going out. We're going to have early rows coming in, late rows going out. It's not going to be a lot of it, but if you're real early or real late, you're going to see oncoming traffic on the Kawasaki and Suzuki and KTM. We don't want you on the tank trail. We don't want anybody on the tank trail because all the military vehicles are going to be burning it up today. Everybody stays south. Nobody goes north. It's all aired off and spectator points and resets and the whole nine yards. Nobody go north. For your service department, for your support trucks, we want you on the other side of this blacktop road. We don't want you on this side, and I see the Suzuki van is already on this side. We want you on the other side. The gas stop is on this side. We don't want anybody in the gas stop. No support people, no support trucks. Nobody but the rider in the gas stop. Crash your motorcycle. This is how we do the canyon jump. I want to talk about the third loop. We call it Devil's Swamp. John Reed wanted to call it Blackwater. I said, no, that's been done. I wanted to call it the Great Dismal Swamp. But we all decided on Devil's Swamp. I think you will understand when you get out there. It is not going to be a lot of fun today. All you A's and double A's. And the only reason we're in here is because of Saddam Hussein. We normally run across the tank trail, but he wouldn't let us this year, so we had to run through the swamp. And it is, that's what it is, it's a swamp. I want to scare you, because if you don't need to be out there, I don't want you out there, because we don't want to have to helicopter your motorcycle and get it out of the swamp. At 12 o'clock today, they will have a live fire across the military road. That means real shells, lots of racket, all kind of noise, might be flashes of light, and no telling. And you're going to be close. You should be okay. They don't miss very often. There's not a road crossing guard there. It's not a designated road crossing. If you get out on the road, it can get us in trouble. It can get you to the house. So stay off the roads. Rather, go alongside of them, just like the Arabs say. Yes, you may see a rider over yonder. Yes, you might overawe the event if you go over there. But you got to get by my observation checks. And they're going to be out there. Don't miss them. And I don't want to hear entrapment, because that's what we're doing. We are trying to entrap you people. The observation checks are real. Don't miss them. Everybody understand the B-rider cutoff at the second gas. Come to your truck. If you're in a four-stroke, but be aware that the mile markers might be a little strange.
If you already please.
Any questions?
Gas
stop. Not at all. The gas stop is on this side of the blacktop, right there. Hey, it's right where.
Honey, you gotta get. Thank you.
Well, we separate ours. Right.
Oh yeah, there's a tank road. 35 mile an hour maximum on that. There's going to be tanks over there, and there's also going to be
speed limit.
35 miles on that. On the tank road. That's all he said in the writers meeting. His comment was the MPs will be out there. They carry M16. Do whatever you have to do if you get stopped.
Law enforcement. Huh? Okay, that's going to go on the bike.
There are also
on the helmet that goes on the bike. I think
there also is a live fire exercise at noon. So if you hear a lot of thunder, or a lot of banging and stuff like that, and seeing flashes, just make sure you stay.
Okay, so this, how many enduros have you ridden in so far?
This will be my third one. I rode one in South Carolina and I rode one in Florida last week. So I'm learning as I go, basically.
And how did you do?
The first one, let's see, I think I finished, I won my class and was in like the top 10 overall. And then the one down at the Alligator, I won my class also and finished third overall. So I did pretty well, considering that I'm really new to timekeeping and keeping track of all these averages and computers, and it's a lot different than what I'm used to doing.
So it's more difficult riding?
Yeah, it's a lot more technical, a lot more thinking that you have to do during the race. Instead of just starting off and going as fast as you can go for 3 hours, which is what I'm used to doing, it's starting off and pay attention to your odometer and your computer and trying to match mileages and also look at the trail, so there's a lot more going on.
Do you think the trail's going to be out there like with the weather the way it's been?
Looks pretty wet, so it should be pretty tough, and I got a pretty late row, which means there'll be a lot of people that have already gone through the trail that I'm going to see, and it'll probably be pretty deteriorated by the time I get there, so it'll be tough.
All right.
Well, you know, the National Enduro Series, it's a tough series, and I would like to definitely take the title home with me. After the first race, you know, I won, so this being the second one, we'll find out after today what my chances are going to be.
Have you done anything different this year to prepare for this?
Well, personally, I've taken my training and my practicing a lot more serious last year and this year. So I'm really looking forward to today's event and the whole season.
Okay, how about the Kawasaki effort and the bike itself?
Well, you know, Team Green and Kawasaki, our machinery's been flawless. We've had great success the last couple years, and hopefully we can continue that success this year.
You win today, you think it's going to be hard for anybody to catch you?
No. This, you know, I mean, winning today would be fantastic, but riders like Kevin Hines and Kurt Huff and Randy Hawkins, Jeff Russell, you know, there's 8 or 9 more races. It's going to be a tough season.
Too early in the morning.
I'm from the West Coast. So I've only been here for like a day and a half, so okay. Get up at 5:30. It's like 3:30 in the morning for me. It's just hard to get woken up and get ready to go. Today's gonna be, it's gonna be tough today. It's gonna be difficult. We'll see what happens.
Thank you.
doesn't have to look pretty, it just has to be functional.
Trying to make me giggle over there.
Okay, Kevin, you switched brands this year. How do you like the new bike?
I like it a lot. I'm still adjusting to a few little things. There's some different characteristics of the bike. I really like it. I think as soon as I really adapt to it, I'll pick up my speed a great percentage.
What do you think your chances are today with the weather?
Well, this weather suits my riding style fine. The more it rains, the better for me. I'm really looking forward to it. The first round, I ended up second. This round, I hope to go out and win.
How does the Suzuki compare to the European bikes you've run?
The Suzuki, there's a lot of things that are superior on the Japanese bikes now. I think the Europeans are a little bit behind, but they're all good bikes. You build them to suit your riding style, I think.
All right.
Oh, really? That's great.
I won't be in park for me. I will in the morning and afternoon.
Yeah.
hoping they'd get an end over. He almost did. He put his hand on the brakes and go right over. Route is just at the right spot. I enjoyed the
team.
get him out of the way before the next riders come through.
Y'all take his?
Yeah.
Hand it back at the camp, but I just want to keep score.
I'll take care of it.
Okay.
Who cares? I done lost that fender fork. Was this a candy jump?
No.
Oh, God, that's worse enough.
How's it going so far?
It's going pretty good. You know, the trail's really good. It's wet. The third loop are telling us it's going to be really a lot of swamps and that. I can believe it. But so far, everything's working good. Just sort of get you warmed up a little bit. You know, have an opportunity just to sort of get used to the area and get a feel for the bike and everything. So everything's going good so far.
Guys in front of us, cutting off the beam.